with your mouth watering because you want to see the goals, Jacob, and we haven't seen any. Why would we not see a goal in this first half, according to you, in this game?
One of the things is that I could say that the goalkeeper on the Sofapaka side has been brilliant in terms of timing of the action, the
that's
crosses.
That's Justin Dikumana.
And Dikumana has been very nice, and that's the reason why he will be in the AFCON with the Burundi side. And that's why Sofapaka actually broke the bank to buy him.
Yes.
And when you look at the action, mostly it's been midfield play where KCB. Trouble.
It is. Let's look at Abuko that you're talking about. They're calling him Simon Munala in the game itself. Now, here they are. Now, this forced, actually, Mr. Dikumana to parry it out, or at least to make sure that it wasn't heading into the net. That header bounced off of the ground. I first thought there was a touch by the goalkeeper, but then realized later on that there was no touch there.
Well, Abuka out jumping everybody in that defense, and that was the first opportunity that came to Sofapaka to KCB's side. And Dikumana did just well to make sure that he the ball went over the bar.
Normally, when it bounces down and then it's going up, it becomes very difficult for both the defenders to pick it up and even the goalkeeper to get it.
Well, it is, but Dikumana, I'll tell you, has done very well, and Dikumana has been the man that has kept a blank sheet for Sofapaka in the first 45.
You know, I talked to him the last time and asked him how he did it. He told me, "Hiyo ndio kazi ambayo wameniletea hapa." So he said that's the job for which they've brought him to Nairobi. He had a very good, pick and dive on this one. And with a smile as well. I don't know whether he's laughing at the defenders or he's marveling at that shot coming towards him.
You know, football is supposed to be a fun game. And Dikumana has made this look very... a big fan here.
Look at that. Just, waving that one away on the left. And that was a crucial touch. Crispin couldn't get to it, although he was already angling for it.
Well, Abuko was also on the other side, on the blind side. And if that touch from Dikumana was not there, then we'll be talking about a different kind of story.
Would
here.
Would you say Dikumana is playing just as much as Faina Jacobs in defense for the Sofapaka side?
They know that Casey...
moja kwa moja ndio kule Karibangi Sharks wanakufa kwa magoli mawili kwa nunge mikononi mwa Task FC. Pembeni kule anatoka vizuri, jaribu kuunganisha moja chini kwa chini, mlinda mlango anafanya kazi safi kwenda mzima mzima na mtatalishwa kadi ya manjano hapa asipochunga. Ndio manaka alimgonga huyu ni Simon analishwa kadi ya manjano. Manaki ilikuwa ni mzima mzima akienda moja kwa moja kujaribu kuwai ule mpira na kamgonga mlinda mlango Justin Dikumana. Huyu mwamuzi sijaona kitabasamu tangu dakika ya kwanza. Na maamuzi hayo kidogo yanamfanya Simon Munala Abuka kupiga matuta usoni akiwa ameghadhabishwa na maamuzi hayo. Lakini kwa mtazamo wangu